Civil environmental engineers design the infrastructure that we use. The roads, the bridges, the water systems, the power plants. Historically, we've relied on data from the past to help us understand how these systems will encounter future conditions, things like temperature, precipitation, extreme events. In our Climate Adaptation for Infrastructure initiative, we're using high-resolution climate data to inform how engineering designs will perform over their long lifetime. This includes understanding future rainfall, future temperature, and future extreme events. All of these will help us move the field forward towards incorporating climate resiliency from the beginning of infrastructure design. Stormwater management is a major problem in many U.S. cities. Increased urban runoff has led to localized flooding, as well as combined sewer overflow events, which put pollution into our waterways. Cities are facing multi-billion dollar investment requirements to fix this infrastructure. One of the ways to deal with this is stormwater management infrastructure. This can be traditional gray infrastructure like concrete and pipes, or green infrastructure that uses vegetation to retain water. All of these systems will need to be designed for maximum performance and lowest life cycle cost under a wide range of climate futures. Another area we're focused on is the energy sector. Rising temperatures, changes in precipitation, and changes in extreme events is going to affect the way that we make, move, and use energy. Our analysis will help inform adaptation options for utilities, customers, and for engineers, and all of this will lead to a more climate-resilient energy system. One of the challenges is incorporating flexible, robust, and adaptive designs in an environment where there are not currently any engineering standards or methods. This is going to require creativity, innovation, and adaptability by practicing engineers to incorporate the highest possible performance at the lowest possible cost, as well as mitigate risks that are posed by near-term, mid-term, and long-term climate threats.